Metastatic bone cancer pain integrates both neuropathic and inflammatory mechanisms. A series of events, including bone mechanical compression, vessel ischemia, and the release of inflammatory factors, cause exposed nerve endings to become irrevocably damaged. As the cancer progresses, the severity of the pain increases, making it one of the most painful conditions an individual can experience. The complexity of metastatic bone cancer pain is due in part to the unique properties of the affected tissue. Bone is a hardened, mineralized matrix that supports a rich vascular supply and dense neuronal network beneath its surface. Within its walls, bone houses many cells, including those that regulate its formation and degradation. Neoplastic cells most often successfully invade bone at the metaphyseal plate, where circulatory turbulence is minimal. Upon settling, these cancer cells release factors that target local cells, chiefly osteoblasts, encouraging them to activate. Hyperactivated osteoblasts have increased surface expression of the RANK ligand. These surface proteins induce cellular changes in nearby monocytes, which begin to fuse and mature into osteoclasts. When the metastasis originates in breast tissue, there is a great increase in osteoclastogenesis. In this case, despite increased osteoblast hypertrophy and activation, osteoclast hyperplasia results in net resorption. The thinning of bone results in two key mechanical events that set the stage for neuropathic pain. First, the release of factors from the matrix, and second, the exposure of neurovascular beds from the endosteal surface. In the first event, factors embedded within the mineral matrix of bone are released during osteolysis. Some of these factors nurture and stimulate the tumor, which subsequently activates more osteoblasts, which then induce further osteoclast proliferation. This vicious cycle ensures the expansion of the growing tumor, which compresses and compromises the weakened bone architecture, leading to fractures and pain. At the same time, severe bone destruction leads to the persistent exposure of neurovascular beds. Without the structural protection of bone, blood flow is restricted or interrupted by the expanding tumor. Sympathetic nerve fibers surrounding these vessels are damaged. Alongside these mechanical events, the inflammatory aspect of cancer pain is unfolding. Hyperactivated osteoclasts release large amounts of acid as they frantically resorb bone. Protons further stimulate osteoclast activity. Thus, pH is progressively driven lower, and sensitizing factors are increasingly released from the bone. In the low pH, acid-sensing ion channels on nociceptor nerve endings cause membrane depolarization. In this perpetually acidic microenvironment, nerves begin to fire at higher amplitudes and greater frequencies. In the microenvironment created by the tumor, nerves are continually exposed to cytokines, interleukins, prostaglandins, and many other factors. Under such adverse conditions, nociceptors become increasingly sensitive, firing to the smallest mechanical and chemical stimulation, and even spontaneously. These damaged nerve endings then release their own factors, which further aggravate surrounding nerve endings. In metastatic bone cancer, pain results from mixed pathological mechanisms. From mechanical and chemical stresses, local nerves become irreversibly damaged, leaving them in a neuropathic state. As the peripheral tissues continue to deteriorate, increased firing paves the way for adverse changes to dorsal root ganglia, and eventually spinal structures that also become afflicted, resulting in an enhanced level of continuous pain.